Today is November 5th, 2024. Here in the United States of America, that means today is Election Day, where we get a vote. Yep, that has a lot of weight behind it. And we'll see which way that weight goes today. On the left side, we have Bunny. On the right side, we have Fanti. But today, hello, Matt Bomber, how's it going? I hope you're doing well. Hopefully your election day, if it is election day for you, hasn't been stressful. But understandably, it's a very stressful time. Hello, Hugh. How's it going? How are you doing? It's election day. I am. How are you? You are stressed. Oh, Matt Bomber, I'm sorry to hear that. Unless you meant that you are well, then that's great. Hopefully you're doing well. I'm hanging in there. It's a very tumultuous time right now in the old US of A, so let's take a time to just go soft and slow. Hello there, NASCAR John Deere, Reason Hill and Brazendale. How you doing? No, my bad, I mean I'm well. That's great to hear, Matt Bomber. That's great to hear. Today, I just want to take it soft and slow. Because things are going really fast right now. No Roblox today, NASCAR John Deere. Because I felt that when I was starting up the stream. I'm still getting issues with my computer. I was hoping I'd get those resolved, but I couldn't. So I can't stream from my computer anyway. And I felt that with all the stress going on today, it's nice to just take it slow. I saw you were streaming Farming Simulator today. NASCAR John Deere. Hopefully you enjoyed that. And hopefully you can enjoy Roblox if you want to play it on your own, but that's not the intention for today. Yes, I was. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you're looking forward to Farming Simulator 2025. Even on a day like this, where tensions are high, and hopefully voter turnout is high, because that's how democracy thrives and all that stuff. Alright, let me actually go to my channel now to see if I can monitor my... Oh yeah, let me also... Here. There we go. I'm not in America. It's not vote day for me. That's good. That's, so, Matt Bomber, that's great for you. And then you don't have to worry about, you know, things. Well, you still do have to worry about whatever else you got going on in your life. But you said that you're doing well, so that's great. That's great. I'm not playing Roblox. I got rid of it. You want me? No. Since I don't play it no more, then what? At NASCAR John Deere, don't give away your account, even if you don't play it anymore. Because maybe one day there'll be a you that wants to go play again, and you're like, oh no, I don't have my account anymore. I'm on your anus. No, it's pronounced Uranus, if you're a nerd. T. Okay, let's see how loud this audio sounds. I can go pretty hard with them. Nope, it's okay. Well, Matt Bomber, I'd still recommend you hold on to that account just for yourself, you know? Alright, let's post that. I'm posting to TikTok story. I have a TikTok account, and now I'm posting stories. And I'm posting this one right now. Oh, that just got loud. I wasn't expecting that. Look, it's a picture of me from earlier today, saying I wrote in Buffalo Bills players on my ballot, because I did. Not for you, no. Everyone only like a couple times, and only in cases where there was one person running and I didn't care, didn't know who they were, so I just wrote in Buffalo Bills player. Because that was fun. Isn't it fun to have fun, huh? But also, how are you on Uranus right now? That sounds crazy. How could that even be possible? I have to go now. Are you going on a date? Well, good luck there, Mad Bomber. Hopefully things go well. And hopefully things are meant to be. I appreciate you coming by here, even when you're trying to rush to a date. Have a great day, week, month, and the rest of your life, and I can't wait to see you next time. Have a good one, Mad Bomber. Let's get back to taking it slow. Ooh, whoops, sorry about that. She's from Mars? You'll be an impressive couple then, huh? Impressive couple interstellar people going out on a date. Have fun. Have fun. And don't get lost in the, you know, the asteroid belts that you'll come across. If you're coming from Uranus, she's in Mars, one of y'all's gonna have to cross the asteroid belt there. Not the Kuiper belt, at least. That's far out there. I don't like how I have to be very loud with those and very forceful with them to make them make noise. So, I might switch to whispering so I can raise the gain and not be so loud. Yeah, why am I doing it on that? I need to do it on here. Let me raise the gain on this microphone. Really quick. Oh, it doesn't want to work right now. There we go. All right, let me raise that just a bit. And now we'll see how it sounds. I'm reading a journal on anglerfish. Ew, that sounds like it's interesting. Just anglerfish in general. Just all types of anglerfish or on one in particular. All right, back to the soft and the slow. It's accurate. Aussies, cry now, would you? Just copy and paste this really quick, so we'll do some more talking. How's it going? It's election day, you know. That's still wild. It's here. It's right now. Also, I feel like this red light's a bit oppressive. Oh yeah, that's all. Now the blue's overpowering it a little bit, which I don't mind. It's an interesting color dynamic. All right, did you vote? Election day ASMR. Perfect. Let's listen to this one more time, and then we can hit publish, and let's get back to the ASMR, shall we? I'm realizing you don't see my eyes in that one, and I was intending for you to see my eyes, but you can't because my face is in the way, which kind of sucks, but it is what it is. I'm noticing that now, and that lessens the effect of the clip there, but again, it is what it is. And publish. Sure, why not? There we go. It'll have to do. It's like in that really classic epic movie, Shrek. That'll do, donkey. That'll do. Speaking of donkey, we have bunny. I don't have a donkey, Belsey, but I have a bunny, and bunny's got like the same ears and is quadrupedal in a relatively similar way, and it's got like the whole snout there, so it works, you know? You see that, and you go, okay. That works, and Fandy's just an elephant, so that's pretty spot on for the GOP.
was talking about in the previous stream. So you can't change the size of the selection area you have for the clip, and that doesn't work for what I wanted to do, which I hate. That makes me upset. All right, let's get you some money now. It'll still be my right hand, but enjoy right hand money. So much. All right, let me try using my right hand. So we're gonna get some left-handed Pelsey here. What have you all been waiting for? Some left-handed Pelsey. Left-handed Bunny the Pelsey. Isn't Bunny so cute? Isn't Bunny so cute with a little scrunchie? All right, let's get you some Bunny. So much. Why would I? supposed to make this one any larger. It just stays tiny. I could just zoom in on my tiny face in the corner, and I can't make it any larger. No, that was more of the screen. It's so stupid. It's so stupid. I hate this. Twitch is just the worst at designing things. My God. I hate using Twitch so much. Just using it makes me want to switch to any other platform. But the only other one is like YouTube, and that's not as good for stuff that I do like this. So, I don't know. I don't know. Alright, screw it. I'm just gonna like make it in CapCut. It's all the ASMR clips I've made previously for the MOA and the Jellyfish hat. Right now I gotta make this one. In order to do that, I'm gonna have to duplicate this layer. This is what I'd do before. Twitch is on. Where's duplicate? There's duplicate. There we go. Actually, no. We're going to add an overlay. The overlay is going to be that same video. They're just going to mute the main track, so we only hear one track. We're going to make, also, we're going to need to, change the aspect ratio. 16 by 9 to 9 by 16. Now we zoom in what we want to go where. Alright, so we're gonna wanna have the Belzies. Very, very easy to see view. Come on, this is difficult to do. No, stop it. Stop going at an angle. There we go. Okay, so let's. Slow and soft ASMR. And this is probably what it's going to be for most of the time. I voted for Trump. It's my first time being able to vote. Congratulations on voting, King Bobby. Voting's a very, very big thing to do. I remember the first time I could vote, and I didn't want to, but I was in social studies class, and my teacher made me, and I was like, dang it, I didn't want to have to vote right now. I wanted to go home and think about it first, but he just made me right then, right there in class. So my first time voting was a bit of a weird experience, but I voted by mail. So I got my ballot in the mail. I filled it out on my couch with Olive, like walking on top of the paper, so I took a cute picture. And yeah, voting's a big responsibility. Congratulations on now being exercised your right. Because rights are important here, and that's what makes a democracy run. So, we got ourselves some voter participation here in chat. Thank you for voting. Your clothes are pretty. They are right. This is a USA romper. I was thinking about wearing this, my USA tank top. It's stars and stripes as well. Or I have an Abraham Lincoln shirt. It says rad, white, and blue, and he's got sunglasses. That one's pretty cool. But I figured just going with the romper so I can unzip it if I get, you know, too hot. There's my belly. But thank you. I appreciate that. And hopefully you're both doing well today, because it's an anxious day for everyone out there not knowing. Bro, I just love your vibe, King Bobby. I appreciate that. Thank you. We're not here to have a bad vibe, spread hate, unless it's for people. Unless it's for people who put their toilet paper on backwards. I hate you if you put your toilet paper on backwards, and you know which way is backwards and which way is the right way. Wow, you have many options. I do. I have. You know what? Let me show you what this. I have. This is my closet. This isn't even a fraction of all the goofy, fun clothes I have. I got a lot, so I wear different outfits for all the streams I do, because it's fun. Got a lot of things I can wear, a lot of things I can do. It's pretty cool. It's pretty freaking cool. So I like to dress up for the streams to, like, make them feel like an event, you know, make it feel like, yes, today really is election day, or Halloween night, dressed up as a pirate and went trick-or-treating, you know, to, like, really just give in to the fun of it, you know. Because I could just dress up in, like, a button-down shirt and, like, wear, like, a plain shirt or whatever and not have fun. But it's fun to have fun, you know? So I'd rather be on the side of having fun than not having fun. That's a lot. Wow, it is. You can see them in my streams. I have, like, not a different outfit every single stream, but, it's just whatever the vibe is, that's what I dress up as. Also, just to let you know, we're gonna just be sticking with this trigger for now. We might move on to something else in a long while. But just for now, I'd like to stick with the relatively soft and slow sounds of our... I never told you about our Belsies! These are my Belsie besties. Look at them, they're so cute. Here on the left-hand side, with my blue scrunchy matching bunnies, we have Bunny, the bunny. Bunny is a Belsie, and Bunny is cute, and I love Bunny. And on my right-hand side, with the red scrunchy matching my red scrunchy, we have Fanti. Isn't Fanti so cute? Aren't they both just so cute? So we have one representing the Republican right side, and one representing the Democratic left side here, one for each hand, so they can go hand in hand to make some nice ASMR for us today. And look, their little feet are, like, perfect to, like, fit around the mic. Look at them, they're just perfect. Fish. So the fishing is kind of broken right now, because I'm not streaming from my computer, I'm streaming from my phone. They're cute. I love them too. They're so cute. I actually made an ASMR video of me unboxing the Belsies when I first got them. I cut open the wrappers and I recorded me showing them and reading off their names. So I think I titled it My Belsie Besties, because that's what they are. They're my Belsie Besties. Look at them. In my hands right now. They're so cute. They're just so cute. Excuse me. Alright, so I still need to make that clip I was working on earlier, so I'm gonna work on that while just doing some one-handed ASMR, so enjoy my right-handed Fanti ASMR. You're gonna get a little Fanti special. hideous. That's just adorable. That's just adorable. Oh, and now you're sending. Thank you for sending the emotes. All the cute ones. Corazón. Corazón. And all of my love. Because she is all of my love. Right now she's in her little cat bed in my room, being cute. Also, I gotta figure out what the heck is wrong with the audio in this clip. Because it's.
Sorry.
Corazón, corazón.
Oh, sorry. Corazón, corazón. Also, I'm going to soft speak for a moment here, so let me know if you prefer that I soft speak, although I feel like that's a bit loud for what we're doing.
Because the whispering is more so the speed I'm looking for the stream, but especially realizing how it sounds like listening back to it. So I think we'll be sticking with whispering and with this trigger of just, you know, the cute little bellsies rubbing around and around and around. I intend this to be more of a background thing so you can stay here, you can chat, you can look at the nice, cute little elephant swirling around on the microphone. But I'm intending this to be more of a background thing so you can just have something on to keep you sane and grounded while this is all going on. If it feels like the world around you is falling apart, you at least have something to grab onto, you know? And right now we have Fandy to grab onto. Isn't Fandy so cute? Isn't Fandy so cute? Sorry, this is difficult with like half of my brain. Usually this stuff is annoying to me, but I can sit here for hours watching this. It's actually very calming. That's so awesome, King Poppy. I'm so glad you enjoyed it. Because there's many different types of ASMR out there, and obviously not all is for everyone. You get those mukbang ones of people eating like blue doggies and throwing up, and it's disgusting. And sometimes you have those ones of just like a towel being rubbed on a microphone for 5 hours and it sounds like ocean waves or white noise. It reminds you of a time in the hot summer when you had a fan on by your bedside and that sound helped you, you know, go to sleep. And I like those sounds as much as I like all the other sounds I like. So I'd like to give that type of sound a go here, and I'm very glad that you enjoy it. I'm very glad that you enjoy it. Because usually my ASMR is a bunch of random things doing a whole bunch of random speeds. But this nice, slow, steady, soft, consistent sound is very pleasing. I'm very glad you can enjoy King Poppy. And thank you for letting me know. I appreciate you. And I'm uploading this as a clip right now, so you'll be able to go back and watch me do this once I upload it.
He hypnotizes me.
Yeah, right? Isn't Fandy so hypnotizing? Look at those cute little beady eyes. They're so adorable. Cute, right? Actually, every all emote I have is cute. I've got a lot of them.
Setup we got here. I could show you, but it'd be a bit of a mess.
We got the nice comfy lights. I finally got a good comfy pillow for my butt. So I'm not gonna have to worry about my butt hurt. It's my back that's the issue. I'm worried about my back. I hurt my back recently and I don't know how. I've been feeling better, but on streams like the football stream yesterday, I'd get up and I'd go, arr, ah, me back, arr. I'd go back to making pirate sounds like for Halloween. Because I was a pirate for Halloween and it was fun. I was Captain Din, who I dressed up as when we played raft. We did a multiplayer raft game. Raft, you have a raft and you sail across the ocean gathering resources and garbage to build out your raft. It's pretty cool. And you get attacked by sharks, and I hate the sharks. They, like, eat your raft and they eat you. But you can, like, kill them and wear their heads, so that's pretty cool. Anyway, I dressed up as a Captain Din for that stream, and then I dressed up as him again for Halloween because we were plundering booty off the streets of Phoenix, Arizona. The precious booty bowls that were left on the stoops of the houses of the residents of Arizona. And we got ourselves some precious booty. And, but I wasn't monitoring that stream, and halfway through the stream, my microphone stopped working, and so the entire second half of the stream is, like, useless because there's no audio. You just see the video of me walking around, and you can't hear anything. So that's why it's important to monitor the audio like I've been doing on this phone. So I'm really upset at myself for that, because I could have been monitoring the audio live, and I just wasn't. I should have. I messed up. It's all my fault. Now the second half of Halloween is just silent, which is sad. Like a whole hour and change is just silent. There's nothing. Oh, now you can hear it.
Well, okay, now that you can hear a plane flying in the background. Let me take a moment to drink some water. Remember to stay hydrated. Alright, let's actually switch to Bunny now. We've had Fanti out for a while. Let's go to Bunny. Isn't Bunny so cute?
That happened. I knocked everything over. I'm very cringe. I'm sorry. I really open, I really try to unhinge my mouth when I do that. 3, 2, 1, kill shot. I go out. I'm trying to think of if I was to sing One Punch Man, which English version would I do? The Caleb Hiles one, the Jonathan Young one, the Nate Wants to Battle one. I'd probably just go make it up as I go. But nah, we're not gonna be singing the One Punch Man theme here. What is your favorite microwave brand? I've only ever really had to deal with General Electric microwaves here in the United States because they kind of have a monopoly on stuff like that. Gosh dang it, General Electric. So I don't know if I can say they're my favorite because they're, you know, a giant monopoly. Started by John D. Rockefeller in like the late 1800s. Because he bought up Tesla Electric, and instead of it staying as Tesla Electric, they changed it to General Electric to make it more, accessible to the people. So that's fun. That's interesting. Wanted to ask something, but I didn't know whether to ask you. Why do you do ASMR? You know, that's actually a really good question. Because my live streams have previously mostly consisted of watching football or playing a video game. And more recently, I've been going out and, with my phone and visiting places, going to events and, you know, walking around. Because it's fun. That's a great answer, Bobby. That is a great answer. But it is fun, and I enjoy it. But the thing is, ASMR content is, like, one of the few types of content that I actually consume on a regular basis. I don't watch gaming videos. I don't really watch sports videos, aside from Tom Grossi and Brandon Burnout, because they're the best. But I watch tons of ASMR when I go to sleep at night. If it's like the middle of the day and I just want something comfy to put on, you know, the TV. If I just want to zone out and I don't want to listen to music, I just want to listen to some nice sound and put on some ASMR. So ASMR content is something I frequently enjoy, and I know what I like. And I like making it and listening to it live and working on it. And so if you saw on my TikTok and YouTube, I upload like 7 or 8 new ASMR shorts because it's so easy to edit them because I love listening to them. So it helps me be productive. I like doing it. I like making it. I like watching it, consuming it, and working on it. So I've kind of hit a sweet spot where I've really only just started truly doing ASMR more often. As before, I just do an ASMR stream like once a month or once every other month. I would not do it often. But now I want to start doing it more often because I feel like I'm more in, like, into the ASMR space than, like, games or sports, even though I love watching the Buffalo Bills and watching football. I don't really know enough to, like, be good at that sort of thing, you know? My football analysis is that, like, oh yeah, this random dude got a ball and did a goal flip, where someone else would know that. design, who that player is, what team they came from, their history, their injuries, what college they came from, when they were drafted, how high they were drafted, if they were a free agent, you know. I wouldn't know any of that. I wouldn't know the play, the position, what's going on the field, what people are thinking, how things are playing out. So I love watching football, and it's fun to react to. So you like the whole world of ASMR? Well, there's a lot of ASMR I don't like, so you probably won't be seeing that type of ASMR here. Like, ASMR that I hate, where just, like, someone, like, up in your face, and going, you know? And, like, you know, a bunch of, like, crunchy or squishy food, and it's, you know, kind of, like, really weird, and there's, like, I don't know, kind of just, like, stuff like this, where it's someone making some nice sounds with something, so I appreciate that. And, I'm having a good time right now, and that's what matters. So, that's the one main real answer, is I have a good time doing it, so. Hey, if I still have good times, I'd love to continue doing it. But there might be a day where I stop doing it. But that day is not the day, because we're going to be here for a while. So again, enjoy, and thank you for being here, I appreciate you. Something that usually happens, almost no one likes that type of ASMR, it's strange, but those ones have like millions of views, and they're like the front page of whatever, and it's, and you see them everywhere. Okay, that's a long message. It's actually so long it got cut off at the top, so I gotta get my stylus here and scroll up so I can read this. King Poppy. Dang it, it scrolled back down when the olive bot sent a donate message. All right. Okay, I'm curious on your opinion about this. I'm almost done with high school. Congratulations on that. That's a big accomplishment. But don't know which job should I look into. Like, I'm confused on whether I should be an EMT, because I always want to tell people who are going to photography, especially editing. I'm very good at it. Or going to law enforcement, like being a cop, or what to do. I'm running out of time. Or what to do. I gotta start looking into college for either career. You know what? That's very valid, King Poppy. That's very valid, because I was in that same position. I had no idea what I wanted to do. And I feel like that's what a lot of people feel, because you're just someone that's going through life, going through high school, and then eventually you're done. And then you gotta, you know, move on from it and go to the next place, but you don't know what that is, or what you want to do, or where you want to go, what you want to see, who you want to be with. But you have to make this decision. It's not something you can just sit on your hands on, unless you just want to waste your time. I mean, but you can, if you want to, like, take a break, sit down, that's totally valid. But I didn't do that. What I did was I wasn't good at computer science, and I honestly didn't particularly like it too much. I wasn't too interested. I mean, I was interested on some level, but not like enough for it to be, you know, what I do for a living. And I took an AP exam, or if you don't know, an AP exam is like a college level test that you prepare for an entire year. You can get a score from between a 1 and a 5, 1 being the worst, 5 being the best. And a lot of colleges only accept like 5s, 4s, and sometimes 3s, so you need to do like relatively well on an exam to get a 4. You need to do very well to get a 5, and pretty okay to get a 3. So I got a lot of 4s, but the one exam I got a 1 on, I only got 1. I never got, I think I might have gotten 1-2 as well. But I got 1 on all of my APs, and it was on my AP Computer Science Principles exam. So, what I thought I could go into, it's like, okay, well, computer science is something I could just maybe look into, because my brother's doing it, and it's kind of the future of things, where things are headed, so I'd want to work in that field. But I didn't really care for it, and I just got a 1 on the AP exam, so I get this result back, and I'm like, oh my god, I'm screwed. The one thing I think I could do, because I don't even know what else I do with my life, is, I'm awful at it. And that hurt, you know. But I thought, hey, let me, do some research on what type of computer science I could go into to see what I could be good at, where I could find my role, find my niche, you know. And I looked into all of the college majors I could find at the university that I got accepted into. Well, I got accepted into a few, but there's only one I was going to go to, because they gave me a full scholarship, baby. And I'm very grateful for that, by the way. And I looked at all of the computer science. science degrees, and I found the one that had the least amount of math in it, because I was like, as long as I don't have to do a ton of math, like, take Calc 4 and take, you know, more discrete principles of mathematics, I was like, no, let me take, like, two more math classes and then be done, and then just do some other classes as well, like small group communication and group work and acting classes and editing classes, because I really wanted to get into some type of content creation. At the time, I was drawing webcomics, and I wanted to do kind of more than that. So while I was working towards this computer science degree that I wasn't really sure I wanted to do, I had, like, my backup plan of taking, you know, editing classes, taking, you know, acting classes, taking, you know, small group communication and, like, business classes. So if I do go into this computer science degree that I did my research on to determine, okay, if there is a computer science degree that I could do, this is the one. And if I don't do it, then I have this to fall back on, you know, so I can work on my skills to do my passion projects that I'd really like to go into. And I'm very glad I went with that route, because I ended up being, what is your favorite microwave brand? General Electric, because it's the only one that comes to mind at the moment. But to keep it short, I didn't know what I wanted to do, so I kind of just picked something that I thought I could do, but, like, gave myself the best chance of, like, being good at and learning, and then I got good at it. I got, in my first ever programming class in college, my average was over 100 because I did all the extra credit. I picked it up. So all that worrying over not being good at it and not knowing what to do kind of went away after I realized I could do well in this field. And then not only that, but I really liked all my editing classes and the acting classes, so I had a great experience in college. And through that, I was able to get an internship. And through that internship, I got my job. And now, that's what I do. But that's just my job for, you know, money. Right now, I'm making content like I also wanted to do, so I'm able to both do my computer science job and also do this content creation stuff that I, you know, wanted to do. So how does that translate to you? Because I just went on a long tangent about what I did. But what I'm trying to say is, even if you don't know what you want to do, or if you're even good at it, or if it'll be, you know, successful, just go out there and try. What you really feel like you could do, even if you're not sure if you'll be good at it, the only way you'll know is if you can try, you know? So, if you want to be an EMT, it's going to take a lot of work and a lot of training. Same thing with being a cop. And same thing with photography. It'll all take time. And you have your entire life ahead of you. So even if you get it wrong on the first try, not just the first try, you can take as many as you need. And it sucks to suck and mess up and do the wrong thing and go the wrong path, but if you can acknowledge that and realize that there might be a better path to take, then what's going to stop you? But for literally what I recommend you could do, because, you know, I don't know every aspect of your life too well. You say you want to help people as an EMT, but, you know, you could also help people in other ways as well. You could be a physician that works in a specific field, you know. You can get into physical therapy work and work alongside people to make, you know, make them feel better. You could become a neurosurgeon. that's a big jump, right? And photography, you can always get yourself a cheap camera on, like, OfferUp or eBay, you know. Or on the Amazon refurbished, like, secondhand page. And just get something and learn and work with it. And then now that you have this equipment, you can see how you really can work with it and how much you enjoy using it. Because you could go into a career with that, but you'll have to be, like, really good to make the money there. So while you're working towards something else, like being an EMT, you could still work on your photography skills. And then if you're, like, after a couple years, you're like, okay, maybe being an EMT is not enough for me. You know, maybe I'm just not meant for this. You'll have, you know, use that time to develop your photography. just you don't need to do the right thing on the first try. Most people don't do the right thing on the first try. Some people never do the right thing. Just try to do the right thing. Sony makes microwaves, so I'm pretty sure I had a good experience with Sony microwaves. I had to shave it down. that long. Oh my goodness. Hark. But I made it like fully professional style, you know, like I did the whole shebang of the editing on the clip. So now I can finally send it in the Twitch chat so you can check out the clip I made. Let's go. Well, I need to upload it to TikTok and YouTube first, but step one, done. Let's go. Let's just try to export it straight out of CapCut. What could go wrong? But first, I want to like, I'd like to watch it. So I need to like, look, it's all the photos I attempted to take of myself before the stream started of me and my red light. Yeah, see, not all the photos are hits. Like at first the photos look janky. It takes me a few tries to make it look, you know, a little something better. Like that's a cool looking photo. But then, once you get just the right photo, well, you almost get it. You're like, okay, that's good. That's almost the photo, but it's not quite there. You take a few more tries, and then you get it. And you're like, yep, that's the photo. That's the one. That's it. So, you keep trying. Oh, yeah, my... off with the text there. It's gonna bother the shnikes out of me. There we go. The first is always the best, then you just start to overthink after a couple more tries. Well, yeah, there's some times where the first photo is the best one. That happens, where you just take one photo and it's perfect the first time. You're like, yep, that's it, I don't need to take any more. It's only then if you take a good one on the first try and you're like, well, I think I could still do better, then that's when you start overthinking it and you keep taking more, but you never get the same one like you did the first one because the first one was just perfect. You keep taking them and you feel bad because you're like, dang it, why can't I do this again? Well, you did it right the first try, just use the first one. But there's some times where the first photo looks horrendous and you're like, okay, yeah, I can do better than this. There's a, okay, I can do just as good as this again another time and it'll be better, which is like a gambler's fallacy there. You're like, oh yeah, I can strike gold again a second time. You already struck gold. Why are you mining still? Erg. But, as opposed to just like realizing that you can do better. Like, okay, this one looks trash. This is trash. I need to do better than this. I need to show the world that I can do better than this. You know, at a different angle, or doing a different pose, or different look. So something slightly different. But yeah, the photo is posted on my X, and it's also a story on TikTok, so... I can't believe I just called it X. Oh my gosh. Elon Musk would be so happy. Wait, can I post it straight to TikTok from here? No, I can't even post it straight to TikTok. Then what's the point? Alright, let's just pull up TikTok manually. Ah, that hurt my ears. I wasn't expecting that. I just, TikTok just played in my ears and it hurt and it was loud. Alright, let's post. What's your TikTok? That's a great question. Here, I'll send it in a moment because I'm working on it on my phone. I'll be able to send the link. But I have two TikToks now. I have one that's AT with T because a dime with Thomas, AT with T. It's super short. AT with T, AT with T, AT with T, AT with T. A dime with Thomas, a dime with Thomas, a dime with Thomas, a dime with Thomas, a dime with Thomas. AT with T, AT with T, AT with T. So that's the main primary TikTok account where I post whatever I want. Shorts of me going out, a lot of Twitch clips, you know, football reactions, compilations of me reacting to football, or just like a moment, like Patrick Mahomes getting sacked, or like the entirety of the Jets 49ers game. And it's me just crapping on Breece Hall because I was playing against him in fantasy. And then I also post some ASMR on there. But now I made a second TikTok account called Thomas ASM Artist. 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 But I start off with Thomas. It's like Thomas ASM Artist. I put that at the start of all the TikToks now, so you gets beamed to your brain. The name Thomas ASM Artist. So yeah, AT with T and Thomas ASM Artist. I still post the ASMR to the main account though, but just so there's one account of only ASMR and no other loud me screaming sounds. Oh yeah, I put up a compilation of me screaming at scary games recently for Halloween. Those were fun. Those were fun. I wanted to make a TikTok short of me going out for Halloween trick-or-treating, but again, my microphone got cut out halfway through, and I'm so angry at myself for that. Alright, now I'm going to... Now posting these, I'm gonna mention Thomas ASM Artist on here. So you can just click on the link, and also AT with T, because I just do the same for both. I followed the first one. Heck yeah, King Poppy, I appreciate you for that. Thank you, thank you.
That's freaking sweet.
Because I, as you can see, I don't have a lot of followers. And so I always appreciate everyone. But you're like 1/13th of my followers now, so King Poppy.
You're like a, you mean a whole lot there. 1/13th of all the people there.
So thank you, King Poppy. Appreciate you for that. There's quite a decent amount of TikToks there. I've been making more recently, so there's a good amount of content to get through if you'd like. Short, bite-sized clips of me being stupid. And loud. And quiet. This is so difficult to do with one hand, oh my goodness. This is so difficult, oh my goodness. Oh no, I'm adding filters. I don't want to be adding filters right now. Stop adding filters. No. Also, I'm dropping Fandy. There we go. There you go, Fandy. Make those sounds. You beautiful, beautiful elephant.
Star-spangled banner, yeah.
the side if I'll respond or not, but that I can easily respond to. I am originally from, born and raised in Long Island, New York. So it's that Long Island that's to the right, to the east of New York City. And I was born and raised there all my life. I went through public school there, you know, kindergarten, elementary school, middle school, high school. And then as soon as I graduated high school, I flew out to Arizona to go to college, and I've been in Arizona ever since. And so, grew up in Long Island, but now I'm in Arizona. So, I wonder if you can tell that I'm from New York, because people say like, oh, well, you don't have a New York accent, but people are like, oh, well, you talk fast like you're from New York, so. Get famous one day. Will you remember me? King Poppy. King Poppy, fame isn't a guaranteed thing. As you can see, you are like one of two people that might be here right now. So fame isn't a thing that just happens. A lot has to go right for something like that to happen. But whether or not I become famous, whether or not whatever happens to me, I'll remember the time that we had together. So I might not remember everything about you. I might not even remember your username. I might not remember that you wanted to be an EMT or a cop or a photographer. I might not remember that you joined me after you could finally vote for the first time in your graduating high school. I might not remember everything, but I can remember the time that we had together, and I'll always appreciate that, so I appreciate you, King Bobby. And I'm still gonna, if you come up and chat and you just say hello, I'll be like, yo, what's up, King Bobby? So, don't worry. I'm not going to become a stranger, but my memory ain't that great, honestly. Arg. Memory ain't the best, but you can remember the feelings that you had, the times that you had with others. But just remember, maybe not, you know, everything that you should remember. But I can always appreciate it. Trust me, I'd like to remember everyone and everything. If my brain was good at remembering everyone and everything, oh my goodness, think of the things I could do. But I don't, so I can't, so I just do what I can. And that's rubbing a little elephant on a microphone. And I'm liking it. I'm liking it. But also, yeah, becoming famous isn't like a goal. It'd be cool if that does happen and I can, you know, just work on this all the time and not have to do a normal people job. I can just do fun, goofy stuff all the time. That'd be really cool. That also takes a lot of work, a lot of time, a lot of effort, a lot of dedication. And I don't know if I've got enough of that in me. I'd like to think I do. I like to think I do. I got the stuff needed to, you know, And again, thank you, King Bobby, for being here. And thank you, Guy Roby, for being here. We also had you. We also had NASCAR John Deere. And we also had Mad Bomber come by. Appreciate all of you for coming by. Thank you. I just want to mention, it's like the hardest working people I know. Like, when, you know, don't become famous. You could try so hard. Put all of your life, your work, your time, your effort, your energy, all into something. And it could just be that, something you put your time into. Maybe it could be something more. So you need yourself, you need what you can do, and you also need things to go right around you. And there's a lot of people out there who deserve a lot more than what they get for what they do. Whether it's people working for a wage that doesn't actually allow them to live. Whether it's people just born in a country where they're immediately born into the worst circumstances imaginable. And they're, you know, not dealt a great hand from the very beginning. No matter what. In order to get somewhere, you gotta do something. And also, things have to happen. So, I'm gonna keep doing things, and maybe one day things will happen. ASMR is now live, and I can send the link in the chat here.
send this thing, please? Where's the just copy link? More. There we go, copy the link. And now I'm gonna send it in the Twitch chat. It only took me this long. It only took me so long. And bam, it's now live. There you go. Now I can see Kairobi's emotes. Look at how cute they are. They're so cute. Even the sad one. That one's actually kind of funny, Kairu. Which one's that? Caitlin S. Yeah, that one's fun. Wait, it didn't actually send. What the frick? Let me send it again. Why isn't it sending? What the heck? I'm sending a link in the Twitch chat, but it's not actually sending. God, Twitch is so broken. This is an awful application. Excuse me, my goodness. Oopa. I reverse the stream and I'll be, no, why is it not there? Okay, paste. Is there something wrong with it? Maybe it doesn't like me. Here, I'll get rid of the... What? I don't know what else I can do here. Yeah, okay, it just does not want me to send. I just made a clip on TikTok and I'm trying to send it in the chat, but it doesn't want me to send it. What the heck? The Twitch app is awful. The Twitch app is so bad. You know what? Maybe it'll allow me to send it on this phone, so I'm gonna need to... Alright, let me try to send it on this phone, so I'm gonna have to exit out of the live streaming app for a moment. Please hold. Why am I going into my gallery? I need to go to TikTok. Do I even have TikTok on this phone? You want to hear some fancy while I figure this out? Why is it a plus? I'm trying to do a D. There we go. I have gotten the TikTok. Oh my god, that's so awful. Shut up. Ow. Oh, I'm sorry about that if you had to hear that. It just like automatically plays some whatever. Just. That's loud. Please be quiet. Thank you. Copy link. There we go. Copy link. Just copy the link. There we go. And now I'm going to go back to the live streaming app. And now I should be able to send the link. Here. Please. There we go. There's the link. Now you have it. Ow. Oh, sorry. Oh my goodness. All right. Well, there you go. That's the link to my TikTok for the new TikTok I just made from the stream. Like, I made that clip an hour ago. It took me an hour to actually post it and send it. Okay, well now that I've posted it on the primary account, I will have to post it on the secondary account, Thomas A. Smartest. Oh wait, you know what, let me comment underneath it. I'm live right, you know what, let me actually comment on that TikTok. I'm live right now. I'm live now. At wait, do I have the link in my bio? Why am I? No, let me actually edit my profile really quick. Pronouns, username, yeah, pronouns, blah 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 blah. Change social, YouTube. Oh, well, you're always in the YouTube, TikTok studio, change display order. How do I add the Twitch link? I know I can add it. Good grief. Social. No. Or, because I know you can send a, you can add, like, a... Alright, well, whatever. Sigh, I know you, right? I am so bad. Sigh, indeed. But how's the election day going for you, Hume? Hopefully you're doing well. We still got the nice, soft, slow noises of the bells here rubbing on the mic. I'm trying to upload this little short I made to TikTok and YouTube. It's taking me a long time because I'm bad at multitasking like this. I have to like log out of this profile now. Well, at least you did get to see David Lebar. You did. And you'll have that memory for probably the rest of your life because that's very memorable. You know, that's like one of the most memorable people I've seen in a while. He's a guy that stands out as like, oh my goodness, that's him.
That's David Liebhardt. You know what sucks about the new TikTok account? Wait, stop it. Get out of here. I'm posting all the TikToks. Nincel, happy streaming. Hi, Nincel. How's it going? Thank you, Nincel. Thank you for sending me the subscription for Quasar's Twitch. I appreciate that, Nincel. Because Quasar's a good streamer, and it's nice to have being a subscriber there. Appreciate you, Nincel. Thank you for stopping by. Nincel Wave, hi. Look, check this out. Today is November 5th, 2024, which means it's election day in the US of A. So I've got two Belzy here. I have Panty the elephant and Bunny the bunny, each representing a side of the political spectrum. You have the left side and the right side. But together, they can make some pretty nice noises. I've kept it soft and slow the entire stream. So it's just some nice calming background noise to have while the anxiety starts to ramp up while the votes get counted in the US of A. Well, also in Arizona, but there's a law that got put into place where they count the votes slower in Arizona for whatever dumb reason. I'll wait until tomorrow to draft up a will. Oh, Hugh. Hopefully he doesn't have to come to that sooner rather than later. Still, if you do write up a will, I want you to put, you know what, Will? I just say, Will, you know what, you? Give everything, each and every single one of your possessions to David Liebhardt, all of them, so he can sell them in order to finally be able to afford some housing on the road. And that still might not even be enough, because it sounds like they need to cover a lot of expenses. But yeah, maybe your will could be the key to David Liebhardt's future. He can tour across the country with the money he makes from, you know, your stuff. But also, you might not want that to happen, so do whatever you want, you. Oh, my foot's asleep. Oh, I just noticed that. It tickles. Okay. I need your opinion on something else crazy, sure thing.
Ask away. Hit me with your best shot. Fire away.
Also, I'm not seeing the chat on my Twitch management stream here on my phone. There we go, now I see it. Cool. Oh yeah, sending the Ninzel Wave. The Ninzel Wave's another cute emote. We've been getting some cute emotes today. Especially the olive ones, because, you know, she's just so darn cute. Now we got Fanty here. Fanty's so cute. Bunny's so cute. Look at how cute they are in their little scrunchies. And I'm matching with them. I got the red and the blue. They got the red and the blue. It's so cute. They're so cute. All right, let's get back to the sound.
Stuck in the sound. Wee.
Let's go. Let's go by Stuck in the Sound is pretty great. I was a dungeon master for a JoJo's D&D campaign, and my friend, he was the JoJo. His stand was based on Stuck in the Sound. That's pretty cool. A life goal I want to do is walk across America for some type of chair. That's amazing, King Bobby. Good luck. Go make that dream come true. That sounds awesome. Don't die. Would you like something cool in particular? Although, did I get cool stuff from Buttons the Clown? Yeah, I did. I supported Buttons the Clown. I don't. You know what I'd want? I'd want a nice framed photo. It can be whatever. Just whatever you'd want me to have a framed photo of that I can put up and be like, this is the photo that you gave me, whatever it is. If it's a picture of an anglerfish, a picture of a manatee, whatever you'd want it to be. It could be a picture of you. It could be a picture of. It could be a picture of David Seabart, you know? I know I got years and years till that happens. You could, hey, honestly, what's stopping you from doing it now? You said you don't know what you want to do. You're not sure where you want to go in life. That type of journey is one that might help you figure that out. And not even going across America, you could just go across a state, a county, you know? Just to see how it goes. If you really want to take your time to figure out what you want to do, that could be something, huh? Well, what would you like my opinion for on that? Because that sounds awesome. Especially if you're doing it for charity. We actually are raising money for charity here. On the Twitch page, we're raising money for Project Bread, The Walk for Hunger, and you can actually find out more about them by doing !charity. Why isn't it sending? What? Oh my goodness. All right, I need to do it in on this phone. Let me do this really quick. There we go. Project Bread, The Walk for Hunger. We're currently raising money for them. And if you donate any amount of money, for Project Bread, The Walk for Hunger, then you can win a silly hat from my silly hat wall. You can win. Someone already won one. Quasar. The Quasar. Oh, Ninzo gifted me a subscription too. Thank you again for that, Ninzo. He won a tie-dye hat, and I sent it to him. And I actually never asked him if he got it. I probably should. But yeah, you won a silly hat. And if you don't donate to charity, you could too. It disappears after I post it. It's so strange. I don't know why. It just does. Okay, so I gotta do this again. @ATWithT. And @ThomasASMArtist. Nope, that is not. There we go. ThomasASMArtist. It's such a good name, I feel. SMArtist. There we go. What? I spelled it wrong. Wait, did I? Oh, because I put at in the front. I'm a goof. What? Thomas ASM artist. Why isn't it? That is sus. Because I at myself on the other post. Why can't I at myself in this post? All right. Let me use both my hands to figure this out. So in the meantime, you're going to have to hear me make mouth sounds. Mouth sounds, mouth sounds, mouth sounds. Some beard rubbing, but now I can't even see the phone I'm supposed to be working on. I can see you though. Honestly, that'll do. That's enough for me. And now, paste. Oh, dang it. I forgot it. I can't type all that again. But why can't I access my clipboard? You know what? All right. We're going to go to my notes. We're going to add a note. And now we're going to access my clipboard from here and paste it. And then there we go. Sorry, this will actually save time. Don't you worry. Clipboard. And now I can copy and paste this. There we go. Copy and bam and paste. Look at that. Look at that. It's too easy. Too easy. Now @ATWithT. And look at that. Did you vote Legendary for it? Perfect. Post. And now it's going to be posting. And now it's posting. Look at that. And now I'm, there we go. There we go. my second account. So hopefully those do well. And now I have to post them to YouTube. Yay, so much fun. All right, I gotta log into my... There we go. Plus, add this one. Done. Processing. It takes a lot longer for YouTube, so I can finally put my phone down and get back to Two Pals the Action. Next. Alright, so caption your short. The same exact thing. Did you vote? Hashtag election 2024. Well, I don't know if they have the same election tag, so. Let a hashtag election. Alright, now it's like the same. Okay, cool. And upload short. Perfect. Now it's uploading to YouTube. And we can finally go back to using two hands for these Pelsies. Are you ready? Because I am. Welcome back, Bunny and Fanti. stuff now, so it's like taken away from me streaming, and it's an issue, but actually it looks like we're fine. It looks like we're fine. Sorry, I have to break the news, but I have to break wind. I farted. Hey, I'm glad you were able to hear me fart, you, before you had to go to sleep. Thank you for coming out here, you. I appreciate you coming out. And I appreciate you considering putting me in your well, because that does mean a lot. You don't have to put me in your well. But I appreciate the thought. Thank you for coming out here today, you. I, again, appreciate you. Have a great day, week, month, year, and rest of your life. And I can't wait to see you next time. Have a good one, you. Good night. Sleep tight.
Don't let the demons bite.
It's been a while since I said that, huh? Oh yeah, also, as like a secondary option for ASMR for reading purposes, I have my pocket copy of the United States Constitution. So let me know if you'd like to just hear me read. Let's get to the preamble here. Well, where's the preamble? Where's the preamble? Where's the preamble? Yeah, they're just quotes from the Founding Fathers. There we go. We the people, in order to form a more perfect union, establish justice. I was gonna do the Schoolhouse Rock version of it, but hearing myself repeat it back to me 2 seconds later is really messing me up, so I'm just gonna read it.
The Constitution of the United States. We the people of the United States, in order to form a more perfect union, establish justice, ensure domestic tranquility, provide for the common defense, promote the general welfare, and secure the blessings of liberty to ourselves and our posterity, to ordain and establish this Constitution for the United States of America. I just farted again. Don't question it. It's part of the American experience. You know, farting and kissing the Constitution, even after not having read it, just reading the preamble. Hey, the preamble's pretty good.
be good at doing left-handed ASMR if I only was doing the left hand and like focusing on something else at the same time. But if I'm doing left hand and right hand, it can still sound fine. Or if I'm focusing on doing the ASMR with my left hand, you know, it comes out better. And as I say that, I kind of actually want to check out on the election
right now.
So let me go to my most trusted political analyst, Kyle Galinsky. Let's just see what he has to say. What's happening right now? Yo, Missouri voted to raise the minimum wage to $15 an hour by 2026 and guaranteed basic leave to workers. That's actually really great. So he's just saying that it's a close election, so that's great. Arg. Let's just see what the general trending page has to say. Why not? Let's see if anything's going on right now. Georgia is trending. Nevada is trending. Latinos are trending. Senate is trending. Joy Reid, Jill Stein, MSNBC, Scott Van Jones, Hawaii. Jared Brown, Hispanic, Sarah's HQ, Fox News, GA for Trump, GA for JNBA. Yeah, okay, I don't need to go through the entire list. Sounds like some election stuff is happening. Let me just search election and see what comes up. To see if there's any, like, top story that people are sharing that I'm missing out on because I'm doing it some more. Arizona's very close. That's where I am. It's currently 49.9% Trump, 49.2% Kamala, but that's only 52% of the votes are counted, so there's a lot more to go. Yeah, this isn't the website I'm looking for. Oh, 270 to win, that's probably it. That sounds familiar. Yes, here we go. Oh wait, what? No, that's like not the. I'm looking for the current. Looking for the current election. Not looking for like a make my own map thing. Yeah, because I can like tap on to. All right. Electoral votes change from. Yeah, live election results. I want to see the live election results. That's what I want to see. There we go. All right. they still haven't called Wisconsin, Michigan, Minnesota, Pennsylvania, Maine, Arizona, and Nevada, so it's all up to them. It's all up to them. Alright, I'm gonna need another sippy of water really quick. At some point I might want to do an intermission to just, you know, stand up and walk around and get some fresh air. So I can continue doing this for a while. Or I might just end it after only a couple hours. Because, I should probably go to sleep eventually. It's a work night. Oh yeah, let me switch around the hands. You're so cute. See, listen to her, baby. baby sounds because she's a baby. She's so cute. She just oo-wooed. All of just oo-wooed. She's so cute. You're so cute. Come on, you wanna come up here? You wanna come up here? Alright, I'm gonna have to let go crisscross applesauce if she wants to jump up here. Come on, Olive. Alright, she doesn't wanna jump up here, never mind. She's just walking away. No, she's still so cute. Alright, I'm closing the door again. Goodbye, Olive, I love you. Alright, we just said hello to the pretty little kitty. Isn't she lovely? Although you didn't even get to see her because she didn't want to jump up here. I mean, you might have seen her on the ground. Actually, probably not. The lighting doesn't go that deep. Lighting don't go that deep. This lighting's not that great for a deep, dark visibility. Just enough to give us a vibe and atmosphere, you know? And of course, I clipped that as well. So I get to clip her baby noises because she's so cute. Yes, baby.
Yes?
All right, she's fine.
Yes, Miss Baby, Miss Kitty.
She's just worried about the election. Little baby. Some point so I can go and give Olive some attention. She's got the zoomies. She wants attention. And I feel like we're going to reach a good stopping point here soon. But for now, let's get back to some more ASMR on the Belzies. I've been farting a bit, as I've said in the stream, so I feel like my tummy's got some rumblings going on, so I'm also going to have to use the bathroom, so that's another excuse I can use to leave. But now I'm not going to leave when I have to. Or when I want to. Whatever comes first, or second, whatever I feel. We'll see. Ourselves another clip. Let's go. Let's friggin' go. Alright. Gonna get another another sippy of the water over here.
Thank you.
as well to NASCAR John Deere for coming out here today, enjoying, after enjoying some Farming Simulator 2022. And with that, I'm pretty sure that, oh, I startled myself. Let's hit that. All right. And with that, thank you for coming out here today. I appreciate you. Have a great day, week, month, year, and rest of your life. And I can't wait to see you next time. Goodbye. Goodbye. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Now I need a moment to, like, get out the stylus. You know what? Here, let's take off the hat to see what that looks like after all that. Yeah, look at that. That's a lot of hair. That's a lot of hair stuffed in into that hat. And now it's out. Now it's free. Now it's about. And now you can see it.
Good night and good luck on this election day.